Now, what is Rice Theorem? Rice Theorem is actually quite simple. Rice Theorem simply says that if you ask for an algorithm to decide if a program has a functional property, and it can be any functional property, then you're looking at an undecidable problem. I don't even know if that comes as a surprise to you after we have shown that basically anything is undecidable. It's almost a surprise now that any problem on a computer should even be solvable, but we'll get into that in a minute. The main question is, of course, how can you show Rice Theorem? And the proof of that is actually quite easy, and it follows the same scheme as above here. So the proof of this general statement follows the same scheme that all of our other proofs of undecidability have basically used. So again, we assume that there's a program that can decide for another program if that possesses a certain functional property. So we're given a program P again, any program P, and we assume that no matter what P is, we can always say, does P have a functional property? Now on the other side, assume that there's another program, P prime, and what we want to do is solve the halting problem for this program here. And then we'll use the algorithm here that can decide for any program P if it has a functional property to solve the halting problem. And the way we do this is as follows. We construct a new program we'll call program X. And this program has only three steps. First, it runs P prime. Then it clears all of the memory. So basically a fresh start for the machine. And this is the only reason why we need this condition 2 here for a functional property. Because if we have an algorithm that can decide a functional property, this means that there are some programs that have this property and others that don't. So we will now add to our program X a program that has this functional property. So run program with functional property. And what we then do is we take this program X and feed it into this algorithm here. What you can see now is the following. If P prime here, the problem for which we want to solve the halting problem, runs smoothly and terminates, then this program X will have the functional property that we can decide. Because it runs this algorithm here, then it clears the memory, and then it runs a program with that functional property. This is also the reason why time is not a functional property. That would kind of destroy the proof of Rice Theorem. But if time is not an issue, then as long as P prime finishes, the program X will have the functional property that we can decide here. If, on the other hand, P prime goes into an infinite loop, then the program does not have the functional property because it will never be able to reach these two lines here. So deciding the functional property for this new program X here is the same as solving the halting problem for the original program that we started out with.